President Trump just announced on Twitter that he has issued a full pardon for his former national security advisor, Michael Flynn. Flynn was convicted after a special counsel Robert Mueller's investigation for lying to the FBI. Then the DOJ stepped in. It was really a remarkable turn of events. Jeremy Diamond, I want to bring you in because, as we know, this was expected. The president has long felt like his allies got into trouble with the FBI because of their association with him. We know there have been discussions underway in the White House to pardon Michael Flynn, and now it's happened, according to the president's tweet.
Yeah, that's right, Pam. And I think you can expect that this will just be the first of several pardons that the president is likely to issue in the final days and weeks of his presidency. But certainly this is one that has been long discussed inside the White House. The president has been considering for a long time. And now, obviously, that he knows that he will not be president in about 60 days, this is the moment for him to do this. Pardoning former national security advisor Michael Flynn, who was only national security advisor for a few weeks before he was fired for lying to the vice president of the United States about his contacts with the Russians during the transition back in 2017. And those contacts happened in 2016. And then he later pleaded guilty to the FBI in 2017 in relation to those same contacts. And somehow Michael Flynn ultimately decided to try and retract that guilty plea. The Justice Department also recently intervened and tried to dismiss this case after that guilty plea had already been filed. And now there is kind of a legal limbo, or there has been a legal limbo, about whether or not Michael Flynn would ultimately be sentenced by a judge. But now that is all out the window as President Trump announces that he has issued a full and complete pardon to Michael Flynn, who we should note has been represented most recently by Sidney Powell, that controversial attorney and conspiracy theorist who was on the president's legal team until just last weekend when Rudy Giuliani and Jenna Ellis, the president's attorneys, started to distance themselves from her.